Professor Dr. Maurice-Stephan Michel and his colleague Dr. Manuel Ritter often operate with the assistance of the new Dyna-CT. The director of the University Clinic for Urology in Mannheim regards the €800,000 for the C-arm device as a good investment. The integrated imaging software delivers high-quality 3D images throughout the procedure for removal of kidney and urinary stones, a possibility that standard static X-ray machines cannot provide. Imaging is enabled by rotating the X-ray arch, which visualizes the kidneys and the kidney stones in a short space of time, 5 seconds, not as a two-dimensional image, but as a three-dimensional image. This enables greater accuracy in creating the channel from the incision to the operational field and in higher precision in carrying out the procedure. Enclosed CTs, which are used first and foremost for diagnosis, do not offer access to the patient. For use during urological operations, the operating table had to be redesigned. After all, most operations here are carried out in the so-called lithotomy position with bent knees and straddled legs. What's special about this system is that although it has been used in other medical disciplines such as angiology and neurosurgery for quite a few years, it has been in conjunction with a rigid, straight tabletop. In urology, we could only work with it to a certain extent since we most often access the operational field via the urethra. Therefore, the tabletop had to be reconstructed in order to enable access via the urethra. Small stones in the kidney or ureter can be fragmented by using shock waves and are then excreted. In the case of larger stones, an operation is necessary, for which, for the most part, a minimally invasive method is used. When treating large kidney stones percutaneously via a small incision in the patient's back, first of all, the access channel is identified in an ultrasound image, and then a needle is inserted to create the access channel. Care is then taken to assess if the direction and location of the needle are correct. If this is the case, a dilation system dilates the channel so that by means of an endoscope in the kidney, the stone can be fragmented and vacuumed out with a special instrument. In a surgery video broadcast live to Paris, the Mannheim urologists are presenting the new CT device to their international medical colleagues. The imaging assists the physician even before the intervention, for example, when feeding the tube into the kidney. The 64-year-old patient here has a kidney stone 1 centimeter in size. It is to be removed with minimally invasive surgery, a so-called mini PCNL through the back. After puncturing the renal calyx, the stone is fragmented and removed via the working channel. The danger of fragments remaining in the kidney can be minimized through the use of Dyna-CT. The clinical result can be verified while still in the operating theater. The other possibility open to us is that we can check if there are any residual stone fragments still in the kidney while we're still carrying out the kidney stone treatment. If the conventional X-ray images do not give us enough certainty, we can obtain additional information with the aid of the rotation system and 3D reconstruction. Around 1,000 stone treatments a year are carried out at the University Clinic for Urology in Mannheim. The new device is expected to make interventions safer and shorten the length of the patient's stay in hospital.